So when you conduct an F-test, you're answering the question, are the variances of two populations likely to be different? And what I'm showing you here is something that you'll never see in real life. I'm showing you the population distribution for two different samples, and both of these distributions we know are normally distributed. The mean for sample 2, the mean value, is higher than the mean for sample 1. But with an F-test, we don't care about the mean. All we care about is the variance, or the actual width, of these two distributions. In this situation, I know that the variances are the same because I made the distribution, but we could also measure it. Here's the width of this distribution, and that's equivalent to the width of this distribution. So their variances are the same, although their means are not the same. The mean for sample 2 is larger than the mean for sample 1. Here's a situation in which the variance of the population is different between sample 1 and sample 2. In fact, the variance of sample 2 is about half that of sample 1. The thing is, though, you never get to know the actual distribution of the populations beforehand. All we can take are a series of measurements for each sample. So, for example, we might take 5 measurements for sample 1. We might see a clustering of samples towards the center of it and send a couple of outliers here. We might do the same thing over here for this sample 1. So we'd see something, maybe something like that. And for sample 2, if I collected 5 samples, it might be something like this. When you conduct an F-test, you're contrasting a null hypothesis in which the variances are equal versus an alternative hypothesis in which we believe the variances are actually different. And when you run the F-test, you'll come up with a p-value that will give you evidence for or against the null hypothesis. And that p-value can have a couple of different values. You can either have a high value or a low value. And what we consider high and what we consider low depends on what we consider for the value of alpha. But anyway, if the value of p is high enough, the variances are likely equal. We don't have enough evidence to reject H0. However, if we have a low value of p, if p is below our arbitrarily defined value of alpha, then the variances are likely different, and we could also say that we have enough evidence to reject H0. We have enough evidence to reject the null hypothesis that the variances are equal. So for example, for a data set like this, would you believe that the variances are equal, or would you believe that they're different? I look at them and I say, well, the variances of the actual populations are probably different because I look at this clustering of measurements for sample 2 and I compare it to the clustering of the measurements for sample 1 and I see a larger range of values for sample 1 than I do for sample 2. I would conclude, just looking at this, that there's going to be a low value of p, or in other words, we could probably reject the null hypothesis and conclude the alternative hypothesis that the variances are indeed different. And as it turns out, this is indeed the case. I get to know this because I wrote the simulation that randomly picked these values, and I know, based on my simulation, that the variance for sample 1 is indeed greater than the variance for sample 2. But in general, we never get to know this. All we see are the data points. The only reason I get to know is because I wrote the computer program that gathered these data. Here's another one. Are the variances of the population for sample 1 and sample 2 actually different? I look at these and I would argue that they're probably the same. I would suspect when we run an F-test on this, we'll get a relatively high p-value. Therefore, we don't have enough evidence to reject the null hypothesis. So I would say that in this case, the variances of the two populations are indeed equal, although we can't say it for certain because we don't actually get to know the population distribution. However, because I wrote the code, I do get to know. In the code that I wrote, the variances of the two populations are indeed identical, and we did not reject the null hypothesis. Here, we would have gotten a relatively large p-value, and we did so correctly because the underlying population distribution, the variances of both, are identical. How about this one? Are the variances for the two populations the same or are they different? If I looked at the range of values here, it seems like they're clustered around a tighter grouping than this range over here. And if I ran an F-test on this, I would likely get a relatively small p-value. And that would likely suggest that the alternative hypothesis is correct. And it would argue that the variances are indeed different. We don't ever get to know that for sure. We probably got a low value of p, variances are likely different, we likely have enough evidence to reject H naught. As it turns out, the variances of the two distributions I used to gather data from sample 1 and sample 2, the variances of those two are identical. If I measure the width of this distribution, it's identical to the width of this distribution. The true variances are identical, but the data seem to suggest otherwise, and we would incorrectly reject the null hypothesis. We would have gotten a very low p-value. We would have suggested that the variances are likely different. We've got evidence to reject H naught, but we did so incorrectly because I wrote the computer program and I know that the population variances are identical. So we rejected H naught incorrectly, or we could say that we made a type 1 error. So to demonstrate this, here's a simulation I wrote in which I gather data points from two sample distributions. In the two distributions, they have different means. The mean value for sample 2 is larger than the mean for sample 1. However, their variances are identical, or the width of both of these distributions are identical. And I've pulled 5 random data points from both of these. This is my first run. I did not reject H naught. I believe, you know, the evidence suggests that the variances are indeed similar. We wouldn't reject that hypothesis. We wouldn't reject it in favor for the alternative hypothesis in which the variances are different based on these data points. I've set an alpha of 0.05, and when I ran this F-test, I came up with a p-value of 0.57. 0.57 is larger than 0.05, so I would not reject the null hypothesis in this instance. Here's the second run, a similar result, a very large p-value, making these variances look identical or very similar. Here's run number 3, a p-value of 0.8, 0.47, still not enough to reject H naught. Here's run 6, variances of the sample look very similar. It's run 15, and run 20. So note, we haven't rejected H naught at all over 20 runs. However, with a value of alpha of 0.05, we would expect to reject H naught accidentally 5 times out of 100, or 1 time out of 20. I say reject it accidentally because you and I know that the width of the distributions are identical in both cases. So we ought to make 5 type 1 errors out of 100 runs. So we'll keep going with this and see if the odds pair up. Right now, I would have expected we would have rejected one value. We would have rejected H naught one time. But we'll keep going, and the averages will work themselves out. Here's run 25. We still haven't rejected it. Oh, there's one where we rejected it. On run number 28, we did reject it. A p-value we come up with is 0.03. So if you plug these values into Excel or into MATLAB, you would compute a p-value of 0.03, which is less than 0.05, which we would say gives us enough evidence to reject H-naught and say incorrectly that the population variances are different between the two. We would say that this variance is larger than this variance based on the sample itself. However, the population variances are not different. So we've rejected it 2 times now. We keep going with the number of runs. So 50 times we've rejected H naught twice. One thing to note, the smaller the p-value, the bigger the differences we'll see between the two variances. We've rejected it 3 times. There's 4 times. There's our 5th rejection. 6. Remember, we expected about 5 out of 100. And there's our 100th run. So we've accidentally or incorrectly rejected H naught 6 times out of 100. And on average, we would have expected to have rejected it about 5 times out of 100. So if I move this up, if we ran 1,000 runs or 10,000 runs, we would expect something closer and closer to about 5% of the time incorrectly rejecting H naught.